Hi, I'm Raj Kumar, President and Editor-in-Chief of DevX, here once again at CGI, the Clinton Global Initiative, and this time with Ann Goddard, who is the CEO of Child Fund. And Child Fund is one of the world's largest NGOs directly addressing the issues of children, and kind of a voice for children, I think, is a big part of what you're doing. And I know one of the reasons you're here is to release a survey you've done of children and what they think about violence against children issues.
Right.
Can you tell us a little bit about that?
We're releasing it tomorrow at the UN. It's part of our contribution to framing the discussion for the next post, whatever the new MDGs will be. So one of the things we like to do is bring the voice of children to the discussion. So over the last several months, we have surveyed and done focus groups in, I believe, 50 countries around the world, asking kids basic questions about violence and what are their suggestions to world leaders. So we've analyzed, we're together, and tomorrow morning at UNICEF, we'll be launching this initiative. I think it's the Swedish ambassador that will be hosting the event. And we have been working on this issue since everybody started working on the post-MDG, really with the idea of bringing the issue of violence for children into that discussion.
And how is that going so far?
I know
we're at a certain point in the process. Explain where we are. And
right. We were at the high-level panel. It was mentioned in the high-level panel.
Okay.
Then the Secretary General's report that had the, I forget now how many goals, but we were there in goal 11, kind of as a sub-goal about really taking on this issue of ending violence against children. And that includes all kinds of things, like sexual violence, child labor issues, violence in the classroom, violence in the home, etc. And we got good response from people because basically it's hard to fight against it as an issue. And of course, there's a lot of issues about metrics, and as your audience would know, that it's really hard to measure some of these kind of things. But it was overall a very positive response. We're going to keep at it for the next 2 years. You know, we'll go into the intergovernmental dialogue process, both in the U.S., but also in all the program countries we work in around the world, getting our offices there and getting them to get children in the communities, again, to bring the message to those governments as well.
And you think ultimately it matters, right? If it is a goal and the final agenda?
Well, I think it does because, though the U.S. was slow when the MDGs first came out in terms of adopting it as a framework for their development focus for the future, hopefully that will change in the future. And I think more and more governments will end up aligning their budgets behind what the goals are. They'll align their goals around the MDGs, and then they'll align their budgets behind those goals.
Yeah, in the end, money and resources are key here, right? And this is how they get driven.
Yeah, and I think there is a process, too, that developing countries are saying, you know, you throw too much at us, and this is a way, the MDGs, to really kind of analyze it down and rationalize it down to some things that everybody can get behind, and they can, in their own countries, they can get their strategies behind that so countries don't feel so overwhelmed. So I really do think it will be an organizing framework, and that's why it's so important to have this issue of violence against children. If it ends up being a goal with a number behind it, or if it ends up being in the text, I don't care right now. I just want to make sure it's there. Because I think it's disgraceful in these days, the things that happen to kids around the world.
Yeah, well, we'll be looking forward to seeing that report when you release it tomorrow.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here this week and for spending a few minutes with us.
Thank you. My pleasure. And I love talking about the thing I'm very passionate about. So thanks for the opportunity.
Thank you.